Hey, you guys, I hope and pray all is well with you all. I am doing well over here. Y'all know I'm doing a 20-day smoothie challenge. I think this might be my last video. I will continue. You know what? I'm going to keep doing my videos because somebody might join me on day two. I meant day two. I don't even know what day we on now. Okay, it's been a week, okay? It's been a week, and so I have until the 21st is my last day. So, that's where I am now, so you guys can join me on this last leg, this last week of doing these smoothies. I had my smoothie and I had a juice today. I normally don't post over the weekend. Sometimes I do, but most of the time I don't post. So if you don't see anything, that's why you didn't see it. So what did you have in your smoothie today? And I feel the urge of just adding juice and smoothie if I can. Juicing is more expensive than smoothies because it just is. You know, you get more bang for your buck, so to speak, because you're adding. Even though you could add water to your juices, but I don't want to do that. I want the full nutrients from the, which you'll still get it, but it's just in a diluted sense. So, yeah, I got my little one back there. She's supposed to be doing something back there for me. I don't know what she's doing. I don't hear nothing. I don't know what that means. I feel great. Yeah, all is well. Thanks to the Father. So, yeah, what else is going on with the Green Smoothie Challenge? I don't know. I guess people kind of in a slump. You know, I've even ran across a sister today who say that she saw the video. I see people watching, but like I said, it was nobody else responded. Maybe because of my last challenge was the GMO, and I didn't do much videos on that. But I did post a lot of things on Facebook because I was getting more response from Facebook than I was here on YouTube. So I'm going to post this video on Facebook. So if anybody want to join me on my last 7 days of the smoothies, if you want to add juices, that's even greater to your health. But anyway, yeah, that's all. What did I have in my smoothie? I don't even know because I didn't make it. I know it has some blueberries and banana. Yeah, what was in the smoothie? Smoothies are much easier to make than juice. It's really the same. If you have a dishwasher, you just pop everything in the dishwasher. But yeah, what else? I know my juice had granny apples, celery, kale, and lemon. And it was so delicious. Here's the little jar, my 32-ounce jar. This jar looked really small for some reason. But yeah, looked like 16 for something to me. But anyway, this is what I had, and I had the same thing with my smoothie. Ebony didn't hear what I'm screaming, yelling. I know I promised to make the tea video, the tea that I make normally every morning. What was in that smoothie? Do you remember?
Spinach, banana,
strawberries, blueberries. Yeah. And yeah, water, distilled water. That's all. What was I saying? I don't even remember. You guys, we got to, let me speak for me because I can't speak for nobody else, but I got to speak for myself, okay? I've been on a journey with weight loss. I've lost over 100 pounds, and I'm talking about since I've been on this journey. Now, if I do an overall since, what, probably 2000, Abby was about 6? No. Yeah. Abby was about 6 or 7 when I first started losing weight. My first time of losing weight, I lost 65 pounds, and then I lost, since 2011, over 100 pounds. And you know, I've been in a sense of, and I kind of been like this with it, okay? Meaning, you know, I'll lose 2 or 3 pounds, and then it's like, let me come back, you know, or I lose 5 pounds or 10 pounds, and it's like, hey, you know, you miss me. No, I don't. And it's not, I do know where it's coming from, because I don't eat meat. Am I saying I'm not going to ever eat meat? No, I'm not saying that, because I might come back here. No, I doubt it, but I have no desires for eating meat. I have no desire. It's just me, okay? I feel like if I'm not killing it, butchering it, raising it first, and then doing all those things, I just, the way how they do meat today is ridiculous. And they've been doing it. And we really should be raising our own stuff, you know, growing our own crops. It amazes me. I know I'm going somewhere else. This, I'm being led, okay? I know it's amazing to me that I can ride across 200 houses or lawns or yards and don't see nobody growing one vegetable. I'm not talking about fruits, because here, most everybody has some type of fruit in their yard, if it's just a banana tree. Mostly, not everybody, but a lot of people have some type of fruit growing. Mango, avocado, avocado, papayas, and, you know, all kind of tropical stuff growing. I know somebody got like probably about 50 fruit trees in their, on their property. But it's no greens. Fruit is very important for our health, because it helps to detoxify, it helps to pull out the waste, and then the greens is rebuilding of the tissues and everything that we need. And that, the majority of us are missing the greens. We got the fruit part, you know, we'll grab an apple and take with us, or grab a banana and take with us. And some of us do smoothies, but a lot of time it's fruit, and more fruit than greens. So it's a cry out for our family, our family. I'm trying to help people to, you know, to eat better and to do better and to get those greens in, because I stand first. To say that sometimes I just miss it. I miss it with the greens. I can go like a whole week or two without, like, just like, hold up, what are you doing? Even my husband, he's like, where's the smoothies every day. He just don't play that. And it got to a time. Well, I know I did stop eating fruits. And then Abby would make a smoothie for my husband, which she normally make one for the family. I don't know if you guys can go back to over a year ago that she became my nutritionist, which just kind of, she used to make smoothies and juices, but somehow we just got down to smoothies. But I did stop eating fruit, so that's why I stopped drinking smoothies. So, I am finding my way. And I want to encourage everybody to just, our people, to just find your way. And I know one of the ways is to eat the greens, you guys. And I'm not talking about green collard greens that have been cooking for 4 hours. You know what I'm saying? No. You don't need to cook collard greens for 4 hours. Matter of fact, it's not collard greens anymore. If you cook collard greens for 4 hours, what we should be doing is steaming it for 5 or 10 minutes, you know. And you can still have your nice collard greens. Put your vinegar, your apple cider vinegar in there, and bell pepper on it, however you do it. But I don't eat mine with meat. And I really prefer mine raw. It's like a whole nother level of greens. I'm trying to think what else. I just want to motivate my people to eat healthy. It's not even eating health. It's just eating what we're supposed to be eating. It's greens and fruits, you know. We had to get them in us. More greens than we need to eat fruits. Some of us need more fruits if we're outside doing cardio work or doing runs and stuff like that. You need the carbs. You need you need that to give you the energy to do what you need to do and the stamina to get it done. But yeah, I just want to encourage our people. And I know this is one battle. I believe all of us, I won't say all, the majority of us struggle with is what we put in this right here. This. Can you stop eating those things that you know is not right or healthy? I remember, I think I heard a brother was talking about he was eating some fried chicken or something, and he was like, nah, I know this is not right. This is my last time eating fried chicken, you know. And he wasn't no heavy guy. But he know, and this is the other thing. Getting the water in. But, yeah. Why is it so easy to sit down and eat a big old piece of cake, 2-3 slices of pizza? Just roll it right on out, tear it up, get a bag of chips, crunch it all up. I that was something, too, that had me going back and forth. I had stopped eating chips for a long time. Like, I hadn't ate chips in, like, a long time, like years. And I started by eating it. This year I started back eating chips, and I'm like, what is going on here? Like, are you serious? We're not going here anymore. You know, like, this is it. I don't want to be eating chips for breakfast or chips when I'm hungry, you know. Am I saying I won't ever eat chips? No, I want to have a control over it. Like yesterday, excuse me, we was in a health food store, and I just picked up two little small bags of chips, right? I was hungry. And my husband was like, who bagged this in? I'm like, go ahead and have, you know. And I'm like, why did I buy these chips? You know what I'm saying? Because we all was like ready to eat something, right? So anyway, I started eating my chips, and I'm like, okay, why are you eating chips? And I feel my body was saying, don't eat this. Don't eat that. I wouldn't say my body, but I felt in my spirit like, don't eat that. Because my body, my flesh, what? Girl, you can eat that little bag of chips. They ain't nothing but a little bag, girl. Go ahead. You know what I'm saying? But I felt like, no. So I ate a couple, and later on I went back to the chips. I ate one or two more. I'm just like, Nope. Why are you trying to eat these chips? Why? And they taste really good. Some onion flavor. Now, y'all know I love onion. But, yeah, that just went out the window. I thank the Father that I didn't eat those chips. I do my best not to eat outside the home. And if we do eat outside the home, it's Chipotle. I'm looking at the time because I'm thinking, okay, I got to go cook dinner. His red pen means I've been doing school. So yeah, I'm finished with that. Yeah. So my findings is, I guess I just want to talk, hang out with you guys. But anyway, I'm going to end this video because, yeah, just spending a few minutes here doing a video. I'm motivating our people to get those greens in. We got to. All right, shalom, my sister calling me. Shalom, you guys. 1,000 rules to you.